pattern library groups our app's modules into components and elements. Both of them have a page config file that lists the individual components of that category. The components attribute lets the UI engine know that now we are going to render some components as child pages. This list contains the component IDs. The IDs are based on each of the component folder names. Let's open up the button component. Similar to pages, components also have their config file. In this case, we are listing the variants the button component has. What are variants, you might think? Let's switch to the browser once more to have a look at the button page. The button page lists both of the mentioned variants. Variants are the rendered samples for a component, like in this case, the primary and secondary button. Each variant can be rendered based on a different template or context. Context in this case refers to the data that's used when rendering the component. Here the primary button is rendered with a text call to action and type set to primary. This data gets rendered in the primary HTML file that is located in the variants folder. There's also the secondary HTML file, which is used for the secondary button. Both of these files reference or include the button HTML file that sits inside the button component directory. I admit this looks kind of weird, but that's due to the simplicity of the HTML adapter. Don't worry about this now. It will start to make sense when we are having a look at a proper templating language adapter. For now, let's see what the button HTML file contains. The HTML adapter basically supports two types of operations. For one, there's the include feature, which we've already seen in the variant templates. And last but not least, there's also variable substitution. In this case, we are using the interpolation syntax borrowed from JavaScript. We are referring to the button type and button text given to us by the context of the variant. Let's open up the component config alongside so we can have a look at it in detail. As both of the variant files do the same thing, we can also save one of them as button HTML and refer to the button HTML file in here for both cases so that both variants get rendered using the same file but different data. Then we can go ahead and delete both of these files and we cleaned it up a bit. Switching back to the command line once more, we can see that everything worked. It will also inform you that it re-rendered the variants on each of the file changes. At first, when we created the button HTML file, then when we updated the component config referring to the button HTML file, and then twice more when we deleted each of the individual variant files. Rebuilding files will also lead to the browser auto-refreshing. Let's see what this looks like when we are updating a variant's context. I'm going to replace the text call to action with by me. Nice, that worked. So let's just for fun change the type of the button to secondary. And voila. All right, let's get back to the original state. And here we are again.